say you in the Bible?
I'm not mentioned in the Bible, but I consider myself very important to all who know me.
But Jesus is most important of all.
I wouldn't know because I have never met Jesus.
Well, if you want to know about Jesus, ask our pastor, Brother Ben. He knows nothing about Jesus. He talks about him all the time. He knows him well.
Jesus. See, a little child told me that I wasn't as important as Jesus.
Well, Sam, I'm glad you come to me and asked me this. You're not the first one that's ever been confused about this. You see, Nicodemus was talking to Jesus in the book of John, chapter 3 and verse 3, and he was asking him about the kingdom of heaven, and Jesus told him, he said, you must be born again to see the kingdom of heaven. And Nicodemus didn't understand it. He said, can I be born again and enter again in the second time into my mother's womb when I'm old and be born again? And Jesus said, no. He said, you must be born of water and of spirit. And as we all know, being born of water, being born of baptism, and being born of spirit is being born of the Holy Ghost. So if you will, I got a Bible right here. If you want to turn to the book of Acts, we'll take a look here in just a moment. Book of Acts chapter 2, verse 1. It tells us, as we read here, it says, and when the day of Pentecost was fully come, I don't know about you, but that just gets me excited there in itself. They were all with one accord in one place, and suddenly there came a sound from heaven as of a rushing mighty wind, and it filled all the house where they were sitting. And there appeared unto them cloven tongues like as a fire, and it set upon each of them. And they were all filled with the Holy Ghost and began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit gave them to utter. And they were all dwelling in Jerusalem, Jews, devout men, out of every nation under heaven. Now, when this was noised abroad, the multitude came together and were confounded because that every man heard them speak in his own language. So, let's go ahead and read another couple of verses. And they were all amazed and marveled, saying one to another, behold, are not all these Galileans? And how hear we every man in his own tongue, wherein we were born? See, they was confused. They even accused them of being drunk. They thought they were strong. But Peter, he took it upon himself to stand up. Peter, in verse 14, he stands up to clear up some of the confusion. He says, but Peter, standing up with 11, lifted up his voice and said unto them, ye men of Judea, and all ye that dwell at Jerusalem, be this known unto you, and hearken to my words. For these are not drunken, as you suppose, seeing it is but the third hour of the day. But this is that which was spoken by the prophet Joel. And it shall come to pass in the last days, saith God, I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh. And your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. And your young men shall see visions. And your old men shall dream dreams. And on my servants and on my handmaidens I will pour out in those days of my spirit, and they shall prophesy. Now, Santa, I would say if anybody qualifies as a servant, you would, as each and every one of you would qualify as a servant. So they was confused, and Peter was standing up kind of clarifying. And if we skip on down in verse 36, he even tells them who Jesus was. He says, therefore, let all the house of Israel know assuredly that God hath made that same Jesus, whom ye have crucified, both Lord and Christ. Now they was nervous. They say, now when they heard this, they were pricked in their hearts, and said unto Peter and to the rest of the apostles, Men and brethren, what shall we do? Then Peter said unto them, Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the remission of sins. Now, I want to take just a moment right there. Remission means payment.
That's right.
As Urban Baxter has explained to us in our Bible studies, even whenever you pay a bill, you get a bill in, it says, please remit. That means pay for the remission of our sins. It says, and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the remission of sins. And you shall, not should, maybe, might, possibly, it says, and you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. And it says, for this promise, it's a promise. It says, for this promise is to you and to your children and to all that are afar off. Man, even as many as the Lord our God shall call. See, Santa, God's still calling people. He's still calling people today. And he's calling each and every one of you out here today. He's calling you, Santa, although he might not have mentioned you by name in the Bible. And yes, unfortunately, Jesus is more important than each and every one of us. He's more important than Santa. Although the world has made Christmas about Santa Claus and has made it about commercialization and presents, and there's a reason for all that. But when it comes Christmas, it's about Jesus Christ. And let me tell you, every day you wake up with breath in your body, it's about Jesus Christ. So we need to take a moment and think about that. And Santa, I'm glad you asked this. And I hope this helps you when you go throughout serving. That you're not just serving Santa, but you're serving Jesus Christ. Has this helped? Thank you for asking.
Cares about us, and he knows what kind of king we need and how that king shall go.
And there are shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were afraid. The angel said,
Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of joy that will be for all the people. Today you will find a baby wrapped in clothes and lying in a manger. This is how the birth of Jesus came about.
O come, little children, O come one and all, to Bethlehem's stable and Bethlehem's fall, and see with rejoicing this glorious sign our Father in heaven has sent us this night.
What can I give him, as poor as I am? If I were a shepherd, I would give him a lamb. If I were a wise man, I would do my part. But what can I give him? I can give him my heart.
Somehow, I have become the star of Christmas. That should never be, for I am only a myth putting presents under a tree. The true gift is that baby born for you and me. He is our Lord and Savior. The gift he brings is free.
Take a moment, if you will. and enjoy this video as you see Sam just giving his life to Jesus Christ. He realizes that it's not all about him. And each and every one of us would take a deep breath and realize that it's not about us. Life's not all about us. If you would, stand to your feet as this video plays. I'm going to give each and every one of you an opportunity as this video plays. Santa's up here giving his life to God. Children, if you want to come pray for Santa, you go right ahead. Feel free to. I'm sure he'd appreciate you coming praying with him. Adults, the altars are open. I want to tell you right now that although this skit, this play, it's just to get each and every one of you thinking. We have made life all about us. We have made everything all throughout the year. We'll be closing after this. We're going to be having dinner after this. There's no more service after this. This is altar call, folks. I'm going to ask each and every one of you, if you would like to come pray, take this opportunity right now. Come pray. There's no better time to give your life to Christ than the present moment. And let me tell you, just because you come to the altar, don't mean you're just giving your life to Christ. It could be anything. It could be anything going on in your life. It could just be because your back's hurt. God can take care of even the small things in your life. He can take care of the big things. He created the whole world. He created the body. So how are we to think that he can't take care of the small things? Just take a moment. When this video gets through, if people are still at the altar, the piano player will start playing. So just take a moment. Pray if you will. I'm going to encourage each and every one of you, if you haven't even talked to God today, take a moment. If you want to pray where you're at, pray where you're at. Just take a moment. Pray with the person next to you. Love somebody today. Take a moment and tell them, I want to pray for you today. I want you to pray with me today. Because let me tell you, tomorrow may never come. I'm not trying to spin scare tactics on you, but let me tell you, it's true. Life's short. The Bible tells us that life is like a vapor.
Play with your toy.
Hallelujah. Let's just enjoy this as she plays.
Daddy.
I'm going to go a little bit right now.